Often, let's face it, we see something out there and we automatically assume that there's something in us that's wrong. I'd like to challenge you to reframe that and start to see yourself, at least consider that when you see something negative out there, it actually might be indicating something good within you. Let me explain. I had a client yesterday who was talking to me about a training that he had done where he could tell that like half the room was with him and half the room wasn't with him. Where did his mind go immediately? It's my responsibility to drag the other half of the room so that I have the entire room with me. He was taking on that good responsibility of the teacher, of the trainer, making sure that everybody was with him. And although I appreciated that stewardship of his class, there's a problem. As he's trying to bring those others up to the level of those who already are with him, those who are with him are having to wait while he does so. And then what's the guarantee that they're going to maintain that same level of understanding throughout the course? This training was a 3-day long training. So what I encouraged him to do is to set that player down. Let me explain. In your blueprint, all of our blueprints, we have a variety of players in the form of skills, values, passions, and elements of our purpose. These make up a long bench for us of great players. We have great depth in our team to collectively play the games that help us win in our life, our relationships, our business, whatever. However, just like in an actual basketball game, we are the coach. And if we are starting to recognize that a player is causing us problems, or someone else, or the project, or whatever, we have to play the part of the coach and set that player down. So back to my friend yesterday, I encouraged him to do that. He has a player on his bench that cares for everybody, wants to make sure that everybody is getting the learning that they need, a good steward of everybody. But the problem, as in this training, is that not everybody is going to understand. Not everyone is going to be at the same level of understanding. And when he recognized there was this angst between those who were getting it and those who weren't, he had to make a choice. And the choice and everything else, that's for another video. But today we're focusing on that recognizing, okay, maybe when I'm seeing something negative out there, some negative circumstance or negative result, it might not be indicative of something bad in me. It might just be that one of my players, who, by the way, every single one of the players on your bench are 100% for good. None of them are bad. None of them are bad. However, just like actual players on a basketball team, they can cause bad. If they stay on the court in the wrong situation or too long, they create havoc. Imagine a player, an actual basketball player, a human basketball player, being on the court too long. Well, they'll get tired, or maybe they'll get a big head. They'll get egoic, and they start to create problems. If they're tired, they're missing the pass. They're missing a layup opportunity. They're not thinking clearly. They're slow on their feet. Well, this happens with your players as well. All of your players have full potential and are for good. They're to create value. However, if they stay on the court too long, then they start to create problems. At the same time, if you had an actual basketball team and the opposing team has a really tall player, you wouldn't want to put in a man-on-man defense, you wouldn't want to put one of your short players next to him. That doesn't make any sense. Same thing with your actual basketball team. You have 100 players on your team. You may not know them right now. I understand that. You might not know your full blueprint. I encourage you to figure out your full blueprint. You have 100 things that you've been given to create value in this world. Around. 100 players on your bench. Do you know them all? if you don't know them all, I encourage you to do so, because when you're recognizing that one of your players is causing problems, and the analogy works here too, about five is what you're looking for. You can only really have five on the court at any given time, sometimes even more like three. But if you see that one of them is causing problems, you need to know your bench so that you can trade them out with someone who actually would create value in that particular situation. That is the power of knowing your entire bench. When you know your entire bench, there is no reason why anything that you walk into, any situation that you walk into, you can create value in every single situation when you know your entire bench. And when you see something negative occurring, some negative result occurring outside, it's not an indication that something's wrong with you. It merely means you've got a player on the court that needs to get off, needs to be subbed. It's also possible that you've got a player on your bench that actually needs to be on the court instead of sitting on the bench. Again, the blueprint process helps you take inventory of all the players on your bench. You right now most likely know and are using about 20 to 30% of your team. So that means you've got then 70 to 80% of your team sitting there on the bench unused in every game. And that's a lot of potential that's being untapped. What could you do? If you knew your entire bench, what could you do? There's so many more games you could play in, so many more games you could win. I encourage you, instead of feeling like you're creating bad in your world, recognize the good that's already within you and use it. You are here to create value on purpose, and you've been given a full team in which to do so. The only thing that's holding you back from fulfilling the value that you're meant to fulfill is knowing your team. The Blueprint Process and all of its practitioners are here to help you figure out your team so you can then go use your team intentionally and with great value.